Welcome to this video lecture. In the topic tutorial problem on design of slip ring rotor or wound rotor from third unit, design of induction motor from the subject design of electrical apparatus. So this is the problem to solve the design of slip ring rotor or wound rotor, and the problem given is a 90 kilowatt 500 volt 50 hertz 3 phase 8 pole induction motor has torque connected stator winding accommodated with 63 slots with 6 conductors per slot. That stator slots and stator conductors per slots are given. If the slip ring voltage on open circuit is not exceed 400 volt, find a suitable rotor winding by estimating the number of slots. So we have to find out the number of rotor slots, number of conductors per slot in the rotor, coil spin, slip ring voltage on open circuit. So full load current per phase and full load current per phase in rotor, efficiency and power factor are given. So let us first calculate the total number of slots and number of conductors per slot first. And to calculate the total number of slots in the rotor, so we have already derived the condition that the difference between the stator slot and rotor slots SS minus SR. So that should not be equal to 0 plus or minus p plus or minus 2p plus or minus 3p plus or minus 5p. So these are all to avoid the synchronous gust in the motor, and then plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 plus or minus p plus or minus 1 and plus or minus p plus or minus 2. So these four conditions to avoid noise and vibration in the machine. And so as per this criteria, so it should not be equal to 0 plus or minus p. 8 pole machine, it is an 8 pole machine, so p is equal to 8, so it should not be equal to plus or minus 8 plus or minus 16 2p plus or minus 3p 3x are 24 plus or minus 5p 40, then plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 and plus or minus p plus or minus 1. P plus or minus 1 is it is 8, so 8 plus 1 and minus 1 is 9 and 9 and 7, so it is plus or minus 9 and plus or minus 7, and finally it is plus or minus p plus or minus 2, so 8 plus 2 and 8 minus 2, it is plus or minus 10 and plus or minus 6. So these are the values, should not be the difference between stator and rotor slots. And so from this we can arrive that it can be the difference between SS and SR can be equal to, so 0, 1, 2, so it can be plus or minus 3, plus or minus 4, plus or minus 5. Plus or minus 6 is there, so 7 is there, 8, 9 is there, plus or minus 10 is there, so plus or minus 11, plus or minus 12, plus or minus 13, plus or minus 14, plus or minus 15, plus or minus 16 is there, so then plus or minus 17, 224, then plus or minus 25 to plus or minus 39, so etc. So like that it can be. And another thing, we are going to assume that based on Q, so based on Q value we can calculate. So let QR is the rotor slots per pole per phase, rotor slots, that is SR, okay, rotor slots per pole per phase. So from this we can calculate SR, that is rotor slots. So that is QR multiplied with total number of poles and total number of phases in the machine, so it is 3. So this is known to us, so based on this for Q values that is give values can be it can be 2, 3, etc. 4, etc. So for different values of QR, we are calculating the total number of SR. So for QR is equal to 2, so we can calculate SR, so that will become 48. And for Q value is equal to 3, so we'll be getting SR is equal to 72. For Q is equal to 4, we will be getting SR is equal to 96 and so on. So this kind of value it can be. And another condition is this is Q, these are all QR. Okay. And the total number of slots, so we have to select the total number of rotor slots that should be multiple of QR. Rotor slots, SR should be multiple of QR. Suppose I am selecting SR is equal to 48, then SS minus SR. So SS given the problem is 63. So 63 minus 48 will be equal to 15. So it is within this range. See here. So it can be 3, 4, 5, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. It cannot be 16. Okay. So 15 it can be. So the difference between SR, so 15, it can be 15, plus or minus 15. So this value is okay. And if we select the total number of SR is equal to 48, it should be multiple of QR. So it is multiple of QR only. So we can finalize this value as the total number of slots in the rotor. Okay, 48 is finalized. And then this is the first part we have completed. Then we need to calculate the conductors per slot. So we have calculated the total number of slots. Next we need to calculate the conductors per slot. So conductors per slot will be equal to total number of conductors in the machine is 60s per slots is total number of rotor slots. And see here, it is total number of conductors per slot in the rotor, so it is TR, 60R, right? So this conductors per slot we can assume is at SR, conductors per slot, rotor slots, conductors, Z is total number of conductors per rotor slots. So that is total number of conductors is 60R by slot is SR. So in it, we need to calculate this TR. So SR we have finalized as 48. We need to finalize this TR. TR can be calculated from a very fundamental equation in electrical machine, that is E2 by E1 is equal to N2 by N1, isn't it? So in the same way, we can write the equation here. So this is for second side and primary side if it is a transformer. So instead of that, we are writing here the second side is rotor and primary side is stator. So that we can write this equation as ER by ES is equal to TR. Instead of number of turns in N2, we are writing it as TR by TS. But here it should be multiplied with K winding factor, KWR by KWS. Because this is total number of windings in the machine. So we are going to assume here that this KWS stator winding factor is also equal to rotor winding factor. So that these two will get cancelled. So simply we can write from this equation the TR. TR is what we need to calculate now. So that is TS multiplied with ER by ES. So either we can substitute the phase voltage or line voltage here so that both the voltages are given. That is voltage between slip rings, that is line voltage is 400 volt, voltage stator induced EMF is 500 volt. So that we can substitute it as 400 by 500 multiplied with this TS, total number of turns in the stator. So total number of turns in the stator can be found out in turn. This TS, so from this equation again, So you can write the conductors per slot and total number of slots are given in the problem with respect to stator. So it is ZSS multiplied with SS. Conductors per slot multiplied with the total number of conductors slot will give the conductors. Divided by 6 is the total number of turns. Okay. And so these two values are given in the problem itself. 63 into 6 divided by 6. So it is 63. Okay, 63 is TS. So 63 multiplied with 400 by 500 is the value of TR we are getting. So that we can write TR is equal to the 63 multiplied with phase voltage or line voltage we have to substitute. So we can substitute in terms of line voltage means it is 400 by 500. We can substitute and we can calculate this TR is approximately becoming 50. Approximately it is 50. Then we need to calculate the conductors per slot. Okay. So rotor conductors per slot is ZSR conductors per slot. So that is, so from this equation again we are writing conductors per slot is 6 into TR divided by SR. So all the parameters we have calculated. So 6 into 50 by 48 is the slot we have selected now. So that will be equal to 6.25. So approximately, we are approximately equating it to 6. So conductors per slot value we have finalized as 6. Okay. So then we can calculate the value of total. Based on this value of conductors per slot, we will be calculating TR again. So it is TR is SR into ZSR divided by 6. So that we will be getting 48. Okay, 48 is the value of TR, and then value of ER we can calculate. So ER is ES multiplied with TR by TS. So on substituting all the values, we will be getting 220 volt. And then EMF between slip rings is EMF in slip rings. Okay, slip ring EMF. So that is root 3 times of this 220. Root 3 times of this 220, that will be equal to 381 volts. So this is the EMF across the slip ring. Then we have to calculate the rotor coil span. Coil span for full pitch. Coil span, so it is slots per pole. Slots per pole, so rotor slots we have finalized as 48. And poles, same as that of the stator, so it is 48 by 8, 6 slots. Coil span for full pitch winding is 6 slots. And then we need to calculate rotor current. So rotor current can be calculated 0.85 times of ISGS divided by TR. So IS we will be calculating from the given KVA rating. So KVA rating can be found by kilowatt by efficiency and power factor. So from this we can calculate KV will be getting 116.27 KVA, and then we will be calculating IS from this. So IS is KVA divided by 3 times of this ES into 10 to the power minus 3. We will be getting this IS value as 134.12 amperes. Then on substituting this in this equation 0.85 IS TS by TR, so we'll be getting IR. So rotor current has 149.63 amperes, and the rotor current is known. Then delta R is assumed 4 ampere per mm square, and for this value we will be getting the area of cross section of the rotor bar as 29.9 mm square. So that is AR is equal to current by current density, IR by delta. So these are all the parameters we have estimated. So total number of slots, conductors per slot, coil span, and area of cross section of the rotor conductors were found. So this is about the design of slip ring rotor. Thank you.